Hello, my name is Ralf Friedrichs. I'm a life coach, an addiction recovery coach, and a host of this show, the Take Your Life Back Today show. Sorry for my appearance, but it's been a hectic day. I was helping a person. But I want to talk about 8 clever ways to deal with rude people, my friends. Rude people are tense and stressed out and can flip at any time. Say one thing wrong and you can end up fighting for your life. If it is a decision between confronting someone and being safe, by all means, be safe. Rude people, how do you feel about rude people? How do you deal with them? You are going about your day steadily, moving from one task to another, and suddenly the unexpected happens. Someone pulls their car abruptly in front of you, causing you to slam on your brakes, interrupts you repeatedly while speaking, gives you a condescending look, bumps into you without apologizing, or even outright blurts something to hurt your feelings at any given time. If it is someone you know, you can usually call attention to their transgression and get it resolved fairly quickly. But if it's someone that you don't know well or don't feel comfortable with, then, my friends, you feel that you can't deal with them. Number one is don't take it personally. Don't take anything that a person says to you personally. What I really should say is that when they say things, it's just their opinions, and don't take it personal. Don't become a victim. Just move forward and try to deal with it. But the worst thing to do is to take it serious. After all, how could you not take it personally when it is happening to you? Look at it this way. It is happening to you, but it may not be about you. Take, for example, the couple who has an argument before heading to work, who then at work lashes out at every coworker in sight. Clearly, they are taking out their morning frustrations on their colleagues who weren't present for the disagreement that they had at home. Number two, it may be a habit. It could be that the person doesn't know that they are being rude. My friend's father has a habit of not greeting a room when he walks into. He enters a room, picks one person out, and starts jabbering away as all others don't exist. For this invisible ones, this can be seen as rude. If you know a person like this, don't take it personal and just deal with it. It is not a personal thing, my friends. Number three is confront person. If it is a relationship that you want, you might consider letting the other person know how their behavior made you feel. This isn't always easy to do, my friends, because some people are just not easily approachable. They quickly become defensive, forcing you to shut down any conversation that might lead to a resolution. Not being able to confront someone often creates a barrier to intimacy, meaning we no longer feel comfortable discussing anything of substance with that person, especially how we feel. Friends, number four, stay away from rude people. If you are dealing with a stranger, walk away. The last thing you need and want is to get yourself into trouble. People are tense and stressed out and can flip at any time. Say one thing wrong and you could end up fighting for your life. If it is a decision between confronting someone and being safe, by all means, always be safe. Number five is let go of the need to change them because you can't. One of my favorite quotes from Maya Angelou is, when someone shows you who they are, believe them the first time. If you get nothing else from this quote, get this, you cannot change another person. Here, I'll say it again, you cannot change another person. And if you are trying to, you are wasting your time. Sure, there are those times when someone sees the light, has a change of heart, goes to the mountaintop, and becomes transformed by divinity. But for the most part, you will be disappointed. Rude people have a right to be who they are, just like you have a right to be who you are. Leave them alone. Number six is be above fray. Decide that you are not going to get dragged down into another person's drama. Yes, this is a decision. It may not make you feel like it, but it is. Don't react immediately to what they have to say or what they have done. You will give yourself more of a chance to choose your response if you wait. This can be difficult to do, as everything about you might want to fight back in the heat of the moment. But with the practice, like everything else, you will get better at restraining yourself. Calm yourself down, take your time, and choose your next move with clarity. Friends, number seven, objectively view the situation. Look at the other person's behavior as something that is separate from them. The benefit of doing this is to will create some space between you and your reaction and that other person's reaction, and it is the space you can decide how you want to respond. Without this space, you are more prone to react defensively, saying or doing something that you will later regret. And number eight is shower them with kindness. This always works. Try to be kind to rude people. Being kind does not mean you tolerate one abuse after another. It simply means that you respond to other person politely, even if it means politely excusing you. And lastly, remember that we are all here on this planet just trying finding our way. We are doing the best we can at this thing called life. People can only act at their level of consciousness, empathy, and awareness. But ultimately, we all want the same thing: love, peace, harmony, and success. Some sort of connection and joy. And we all have moments when we are rude, every single one of us. Please call me at 844-405-HELP, and together we can help each other take our lives back. And remember, God loves you, God loves all, even rude people. And may God bless you and all the rude people in life. Take care, and God bless you.